मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, बॉक्सर्स नकल और सेजिटल बैंड रप्चर इज अ प्रॉब्लम विच इज़ वेरी कॉमनली सीन इन बॉक्सर्स, आइदर प्रोफेशनल और अमेच्योर। दिस प्रॉब्लम इज ऑल्सो ओकेजनली सीन इन सम पेशेंट सफरिंग फ्रॉम रूमेटॉइड आर्थराइटिस और अदर इरोजिव आर्थ्रोपैथीज। नाउ व्हाट इज अ सेजिटल बैंड? सेजिटल बैंड इज अ क्लोज सिलिंड्रिकल ट्यूब विच सपोर्ट्स ऑन द बोथ साइड्स ऑफ एक्सटेंसर टेंडन and at the level of knuckle, knuckle is actually the level of the metacarpophalangeal joint, that is the MCP joint. The extensor tendon is supported by sagittal bands on both the sides, radial side as well as ulnar side. So what happens is when there is an injury at the level of the knuckle to the sagittal bands, the extensor tendon may dislocate. Now, a radial sagittal band can injure and an ulnar sagittal band can injure. More commonly, 90% of time, there is a radial sagittal band injury which leads to ulnar subluxation of the extensor tendon. Only rarely, 10% of the cases, you may have ulnar sagittal band rupture. Now, this disease is basically a tendon subluxation issue and this usually can cause problems related to extension and ulnar deviation of the fingers. Usually, in more than 50%, you will have extensor tendon subluxation. Now, there is a Ryan and Murray classification which classify this injury into three types. Type 1 is the injury to the sagittal band but no instability of extensor tendon. Type 2 is subluxation of extensor tendon, and type 3 is a complete dislocation of the extensor tendon. Now, as I told you, this injury is due to punching action, and so in professional athletes, the most common fingers which are injured is middle finger and the index finger, whereas in amateurs you will see more of the ring finger and the little finger. If you talk overall, most common is the middle finger, that is around 45%. Second is index finger, that is around 14%. The little finger can be around 31%, and the ring finger is around 7%. So 14%, 48%, 7% and 31%. This is the ratio of all the four fingers. Now clinically, you will find these patients come to you with a boxing punch injury. They will have swollen MCP, that is the metacarpophalangeal joint. There will be ulnar deviation of the wrist. And there will be inability to initiate the extension. Now you will be astonished to know that I suffered this injury when I was a kid. And you can see that my ring finger is deviating ulnarwards because of this old injury. So this is a common injury, but this is a commonly missed injury. How do we diagnose it? So as I told you, there will be swelling on the MCP joint, ulnar sided deviation of the digit and difficulty in extension of the digit. These are the three features. Now this problem is reduced on extension. So in extension, the extensor tendon becomes stable, and in wrist flexion, the problem worsens. So wrist flexion will increase the problem of tendon subluxation, extensor tendon subluxation. So the problem is increased with flexion at the wrist joint. Now most of these cases can be treated successfully, conservatively, without any surgery by doing a extension splint or a yoke splint like this, in which the MCP is treated in extension for a period of about 4 to 6 weeks. Very, very occasionally, if a patient is a professional sports person or if the patient is not improving in the symptoms, you can do either a repair or a reconstruction. So if you want to do a repair, you can do a direct kettle clamp repair of the sagittal band. If you want to do a reconstruction, then it is a little bit more tricky, but you can do a tendon slip reconstruction procedures to reconstruct the sagittal slip. What your mind does not know, your eyes does not see. So this condition you should all remember in the back of your mind, specifically in a boxer who present to you with a punching injury and swelling in the metacarpal phalangeal joint. Friends, I hope that I am able to clear your doubts regarding sagittal band rupture. If you have any more questions, you can write us on the comment box. Thank you.